بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، نبدأ بإذن الله تعالى بدراسة كتاب الصلاة. نعم.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. بعد، we're going to now study and move on to studying the book of As-Salah, the book of prayer.
As-Salah, نريد أن نتكلم عن الصلاة ونقسم الصلاة إلى قسمين، فريضة ونافلة. نعم.
We want to start talking about the prayer. We want to start studying about the prayer. And we want to divide the prayer into two types. That which is a fariḍa, the obligatory prayers, an obligation, and those which are voluntary.
Al-fariḍa, الصلوات الخمس المفروضة.
So the obligatory prayers are the five daily prayers.
وصلاة الجماعة على صلاة الجمعة على ما سيأتي معنا بإذن الله تعالى من أنها تجب على الرجال لا على النساء.
And also the Friday prayer, Salat al-Jum'ah, the Friday prayer which men have to pray in congregation and women don't have to.
وصلات العيدين والكسوف على القول بأن العيدين والكسوف واجب. نعم.
And also the two Eid prayers and the prayer for the eclipse, the lunar eclipse or the solar eclipse, upon the opinion of those people who said that all of these prayers are an obligation and they have to be prayed in congregation. Then after this, we're going to talk about the second type of prayers, which is the recommended or voluntary prayers.
الصلاة لا بد لها من شروط وأركان وواجبات، ولا بد أن تصلي ولا تأتي بمبطل ومبطلات الصلاة، ولهذا أهم ما يكون أن تتعلم شروط الصلاة وأركان الصلاة وواجبات الصلاة وكذلك السنة، ولا بد أن تعرف المبطلات حتى لا تقع في مبطل وتكون الصلاة بهذا نسأل الله العافية والسلامة باطلة. نعم.
In terms of the prayer, then each prayer has its conditions and its pillars, its obligations, and also those actions which are recommended. And then there are also actions which, if a person does any of these actions, then his prayer becomes invalid or he breaks his prayer. So you have to know, before you start praying, what are the conditions, the shurut, what are the pillars, the arkan, what are the obligatory matters, which are the wajibat, and what are the sunan, those recommended actions. And you also have to know the mubtilat, i.e. those actions which, if you do them, they break a person's prayer and make it invalid.
فشروط الصلاة.
So the conditions of the prayer are
الشرط الأول الإسلام.
The first condition is الإسلام, a person accepting Islam.
فلو صلى المشرك فصلاته باطل نسأل الله العافية والسلام.
So if a person of shirk prays the prayer, then his prayer is not accepted.
من صلى ساب الرب ساب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. من يسجد للصنم من يطوف حول القبور فصلاته باطلة حتى يتوب من هذا. نعم.
A person who insults Allah, a person who insults the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a person who bows down and makes sujood to an idol, a person who makes tawaf around the graves, any of these people, if they pray, then their prayer is not accepted. Why? Because they are in shirk akbar. Until they repent from their shirk, and then their prayer is accepted.
الشرط الثاني العقل فلو صلى المجنون فصلاته باطلة.
And then the second condition is al-aql, a person having intelligence, and therefore, if an insane person prays, then his prayer is invalid.
ومن باب أولى صلى السكران.
And more than this is that a person who is drunk or intoxicated, he does not pray.
الشرط الثالث التمييز أي التفريق بين الأشياء. فإذا كان هذا الذي يصلي يفرق بين الأشياء فصلاته صحيحة، وإذا كان لا يفرق بين الأشياء فصلاته باطلة. صلاة الصغير هل تصح؟ ننظر. إذا كان يميز يفرق بين الأشياء يعرف أن هذا ماء وهذا نار تقول له اجلس يجلس يعرف السؤال والجواب فصلاته صحيحة وإلا فهي باطلة. نعم.
The third condition for the validity of the prayer is that the small child, the young child, must be able to distinguish, i.e. he's reached an age whereby he can distinguish. He can distinguish between right and wrong and this and that in the various actions. So is the prayer of a small child accepted? We see, we ask him, has he reached the age of at-tamyiz, the age whereby he can distinguish between different things?
الشرط الثالث من شروط الصلاة النية.
The fourth condition from the conditions of the prayer is an-niyyah, person having the intention.
وتقدم معنا أن النية محل القلب والتلفظ بها بدعة.
And we already mentioned that the place in which a person has his intention is the heart. And for a person to speak with the intention or pronounce intention upon this tongue, then this is an innovation, an action which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't do.
ورفع الحدث الأكبر والأصغر وهذا تقدم معنا في درس الطهارة.
And also from the conditions of the prayer is a person having exited from the state of impurity, whether it is major impurity or minor impurity, and we've already studied this in the book of At-Tahara, purification.
فمن صلى وعليه حدث أكبر أو حدث أصغر قبل أن يتوضأ أو يغتسل فالصلاة باطلة.
So whoever prays and he's in a state of major impurity, al-hadith al-akbar, or minor impurity, al-hadith al-asghar, without making ghusl, or without making wudu, then his prayer is invalid and not accepted.
ثم إزالة النجاسة عن ثلاثة أشياء عن البدن والبقعة والثوب. فلو صلى على بدن النجاسة أو على ثوب نجاسة أو في مكان نجس فالصلاة باطلة إذا كان قادرا على إزالة هذه النجاسة عالما بوجودها. نعم.
And then the next condition for the validity of the prayer is that a person removes or cleans any impurity, any najasa upon his garments or upon his body or upon the earth that he's praying. So therefore, if a person prays a prayer and there's some impurity, some najasa on his body or his garment or the floor that he's praying upon, then his prayer is invalid. As long as a person is aliman.
عالم بوجود النجاسة قادرا على إزالتها.
As long as the person knows that this impurity is on himself or his clothing or the floor, and he also has the ability to remove it and clean it. If he doesn't do so, and he knows and he has the ability to do so, then his prayer is not accepted.
فلو صلى وعليه النجاسة ولكن كان لا يدري بوجود هذه النجاسة وصلى بها فالصلاة صحيحة. نعم.
So if a person prays, he finishes praying, and he didn't know that there was an impurity on his garment or on his body on the floor, he didn't know this, and he's prayed now, then his prayer is correct and accepted.
واستقبال القبلة. لابد من استقبال القبلة في صلاة الفريضة وصلاة النافلة وفي كل صلاة. نعم.
And also from the conditions of the acceptance and the validity of the prayer is that a person faces the qibla. And this is the same whether it's an obligatory prayer or a voluntary prayer.
إلا صلاة النافلة يصح أن يصلي النافلة في السفر فقط حيث توجه به الدابة أو الراحلة أو القطار أو السيارة أو ما إلى ذلك من وسائل المواصلات. نعم.
And the only exception to this, i.e. to facing the Qibla, is a person praying the nafil prayers, the voluntary prayers, whilst he is traveling. So whilst he is traveling, he can sit in his mode of transport and pray whichever way the mode of transport is facing.
إذا لابد من استقبال القبلة في صلاة الفريضة وفي النافلة. إلا أن النافلة في السفر يصح أن يصلي حيث توجه به الدابة أو الراحلة أو القطار أو السيارة. نعم. أو الباخرة.
So a person has to face the Qibla. One of the conditions is a person has to face the Qibla in all of his prayers, whether it's an obligatory prayer or whether it's a voluntary prayer. And the only exception to this is if a person is traveling and he's sitting on his mode of transport, whether it's a camel or a horse or a car or a train or a ship, then he prays whichever way his mode of transport is facing.
ثم أيضا ستر العورة أو أخذ الزينة في الصلاة. نعم.
And also from the conditions of the validity of the prayer and the correctness of the prayer is a person covering his awra, a person covering his private body parts that should be covered, or a person adorning himself and beautifying himself with the correct clothing.
فأخذ الزينة في الصلاة أو ستر العورة في الصلاة على ثلاثة أقسام.
So a person beautifying and adorning himself with good clothing, or a person covering his awra, his private parts, is of three types.
عورة مغلظة وعورة مخففة وعورة متوسطة.
So you have three types of awra, three types of private parts that should be covered, three types of parts of the body that have to be covered. You have those parts of the body which there is a severe command, or there is a great command to cover, and this is al-awra al-mughallada. And then you have another type of the part of the body which is light, and it has to be covered, but it is a command which is much lighter. And then you have a type of awra which is in the middle between these two, not as severe as the severe one, and not as light as the lightest one.
Al-awra al-mughallada هي عورة المرأة الحرة البالغة. مرأة وحرة وبالغة تستر جميع البدن إلا وجهها. وعند الأجانب تغطي حتى الوجه. نعم.
The awra which is مغلظة, the parts of the body which have to be covered with a very great command or very severe command is the body parts of a woman who is free and she's over the age of puberty. If you find a woman and she's free and she's over the age of puberty, then she has to cover all of her body except her face. If, however, she's in front of non-relatives, i.e. those relatives who are not her mahram, then she has to cover even her face.
والعورة المخففة هي عورة الذكر ابن 7 سنين إلى 10 سنين. يستر الأبل مع الدبر. نعم.
And as for the عورة المخففة, i.e. the body parts which have to be covered, however the command is less, is the private body parts, the private parts of a young boy who's from 7 to 10, he has to cover at least his front private parts and his back private parts.
وما عدا العورة المغلظة والعورة المخففة هي عورة متوسطة يستر من السرة إلى الركبة مع استحباب ستر العاتقين وأخذ كامل الزينة في الصلاة. نعم. العورة المتوسطة هي ما عدا العورة المغلظة والمخففة يستر جميعا يستر من السرة إلى الركبة مع استحباب ستر العاتقين وأخذ كامل الزينة في الصلاة.
And then you have the third type of awra which is between these two levels, and this is a person, a man, the obligation is for him to cover that which is between his navel all the way to his knees, and it is recommended for him to cover up to his shoulders, يعني منكبين.
نعم. استحباب ستر العاتقين وأخذ كامل الزينة في الصلاة لأنه بهذا قال الله سبحانه وتعالى يا بني آدم خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد أي عند كل صلاة. نعم.
And the recommendation for him is to cover all the way to his shoulder and also to wear nice and beautiful clothes, so beautify himself with good clothes. Because Allah said in the Quran, O children of Adam, beautify yourselves with every prayer.
إذن العورات ثلاثة مغلظة مخففة متوسطة.
And therefore we have three types of awra. They are the awra al-mughallada, which has to be covered very severe. And then we have an awra which is mukhaffafa, which is less and weaker or light. And then we have an awra which is between these two.
عورة المرأة الحرة البالغة جميع البدن إلا وجهها. عند الأجانب تغطي حتى الوجه.
So all of the body of a woman who is free and she's over the age of puberty, it has to be covered apart from the face. As for if she's in the presence of people who are not her relatives, not her mahram, then she has to cover even her face.
والعورة المخففة الذكر ابن 7 سنين 10 سنين يستر القبل والدبر. نعم.
And the least form of awra is the awra of a young boy from up to 7 or 10 years old. He has to cover his private parts, the front and the back.
وما عدا المرأة الحرة البالغة والذكر بين 7 سنين و10 سنين كلها البقية عورتهم متوسطة يستر من السرة إلى الركبة مع استحباب ستر العاتقين وأخذ كامل الزينة في الصلاة. نعم.
And apart from these two, you have a man who has to cover himself from his navel all the way down to his knees, and the recommendation is for him to cover all the way up to his shoulders and also wear good and beautiful clothes.
ومن شروط الصلاة كذلك دخول الوقت.
And from the conditions of the prayer is the entering of the correct time.
فلا صح أن يصلي قبل الوقت.
So a person is not allowed to pray before the time of the prayer.
أو يتعمد إخراج الصلاة عن وقتها.
Or that on purpose he delays the prayer until after the time is gone.
إذن لابد أن يؤدي الصلاة في وقتها.
And therefore, a person has to fulfill and pray his prayer in its time.
إلا إذا كان لديه رخصة بأن يجمع جمع تقديم بين الظهر والعصر أو جمع تأخير كذلك بين الظهر والعصر أو المغرب والعشاء. إذا كان لديه رخصة فله أن يجمع إما جمع تقديم أو جمع تأخير، وإلا فلا بد أن يصلي كل صلاة على وقتها. نعم.
So a person has to pray every single prayer in its correct appointed legislated time, unless he has an allowance from the Sharia. As an example, a person is traveling, he's traveling a journey, and therefore he can either pray both Dhuhr and Asr in the time of Dhuhr, or he can pray Dhuhr and Asr in the time of Asr, or he can pray Maghrib and Isha in the time of Maghrib, or he can pray Maghrib and Isha in the time of Isha.
نعم. هذا ما يتعلق الله أعلم بشروط الصلاة. نعم.
So this is what relates to, and Allah knows best, to the timings of the prayer.
ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى ما يتعلق بمواقيت الصلاة. نعم.
The author, may Allah mercy upon him, he mentioned that which relates to مواقيت الصلاة, the timings of the prayer.
بدأ المؤلف بذكر وقت صلاة الظهر.
So he began by mentioning the time for the Dhuhr prayer.
لأن أول صلاة صلاها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هي صلاة الظهر.
Because the first prayer that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم prayed was the Dhuhr prayer.
عندما فرضت عليه الصلوات المفروضة أول صلاة صلاها هي صلاة الظهر. نعم.
So when the five daily prayers became an obligation upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the first prayer he prayed was the Dhuhr prayer.
نعم. صلاة الظهر الآن أخواننا الشمس تخرج من المشرق حتى تغرب من المغرب، فعندما تخرج يأتي الظل الآن ظل الشمس يكون من الجهة الأخرى من جهة الغرب حتى تصبح الشمس على رؤوس الخلائق، يعني لا يصبح ظل الأشياء. هذا الوقت ووقت النهي عن الصلاة، هذا الوقت الوقت الذي تسعر فيه نار جهنم، نسأل الله العافية والسلام. نعم.
لما يكون الشمس،
يعني الآن أنت تضع شاخص أو تنظر في أعمدة الإنارة مثلا. نعم. واحد واحد.
So we come to the Dhuhr prayer. When the sun is rising, it rises from the east and the sun sets in the west. And therefore, when the sun is rising from the east, then the shadow of the person is in the opposite direction towards the west, until the sun goes all the way to the other side, and then the shadow of the person is in its opposite direction.
يعني الآن عندما تخرج الشمس من هنا من المشرق يكون الظل ظل هذا العمود من الجهة الأخرى من جهة الغرب.
So when the sun rises from the east, then the shade of the stick is on the opposite direction, i.e. towards the west.
ثم يبدأ الظل ينقص 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 حتى تأتي الشمس على رؤوس الخلائق، يعني على الشخص هذا، ولا يصبح ظل للأشياء. هذا الوقت هو وقت النهي عن الصلاة، هذا الوقت هو الوقت الذي تسعر فيه نار جهنم، نسأل الله العافية والسلام. نعم.
And then as the sun is rising more and more, the shadow of the stick gets smaller and smaller and smaller, until the sun rises to the top, to its zenith, on top of the stick, and the stick has no shadow. So in this time, when the sun is right above the person of the stick and the stick has no shadow, this is the time in which a person is not allowed to pray.
فإذا بدأت الشمس تميل من جهة الغرب وبدأ الظل يخرج من الجهة الأخرى، هذا هو وقت الظهر، أي وقت الزوال، يعني إزالة الشمس عن كبد السماء. نعم.
As soon as the sun now begins to go on the other side, and then the shadow starts coming towards the east, now is the time for Dhuhr. So as soon as the sun has gone past its zenith, I've been on top of the stick of the person, as soon as it's gone past that stage, then the Dhuhr time stops.
فإذا كان الظل مقدار هذا الشخص، يعني طول هذا الشخص 3 أمتار، والظل أصبح الآن من جهة الشرق 3 أمتار، هذا وقت العصر. نعم.
And once the sun keeps moving until the shadow of the stick is equal to the length of the stick or the person. So for example, if this person or this stick is 3 meters long, and the sun has gone to a position in which now the shadow is also 3 meters long, then this now is the time for the Asr prayer.
Yeah. ثم بعد هذا إذا غاب قرص الشمس وجاء الشفق الأحمر وأقبل الليل من جهة الشرق وأدبر النهار من جهة الغرب هذا هو وقت المغرب. نعم.
So now, once the disk of the sun has disappeared,
يعرف وقت المغرب بغروب القرص قرص الشمس وبإقبال الليل وإدبار النهار. نعم.
So the time for the Maghrib prayer is known once the disk or the sun is beginning to sunset, and the night is now coming and the day is now going.
حتى يغيب الشفق الأحمر. الشفق الأحمر هو بقية ضوء الشمس لكن على احمرار بعد أن يغيب القرص. نعم.
And the Maghrib prayer stays until the pink light. It disappears. So once the light of the sun disappears, and this is the pinkness that we find in the sky, then the Maghrib prayer is finished.
فإذا غاب الشفق الأحمر دخل وقت العشاء إلى منتصف الليل.
So once the remainder of the sun, in terms of the pink that remains behind the sun, once that has disappeared, then the Isha prayer has started. And the Isha prayer remains all the way until half of the night.
يعني كيف تعرف منتصف الليل؟
So how does a person know when is half or mid of the night?
وقت المغرب الساعة السادسة مثلا، وقت الفجر الساعة السادسة. يعني كم ساعة الآن بين المغرب والفجر؟ 12. تقسم على 2 يكون بعد 6 ساعات، يعني تحسب بعد الساعة السادسة 6 ساعات وبهذا يكون منتصف الليل. نعم.
So how does a person know when it is midnight or when it is the middle of the night, i.e. when the Isha prayer has ended? You started the Maghrib prayer and you can see that the Maghrib prayer, for example, started at 6 o'clock. And you know that الفجر يعني
من يحسب من وقت المغرب إلى وقت الفجر الصادق ويقسم على 2 بهذا يكون منتصف الليل.
So a person counts the time from the beginning of the Maghrib prayer or the ending of the Maghrib prayer all the way up to the true sunset. He counts all of the hours there, he divides them in 2, and this therefore is the middle of the night.
ووقت صلاة الفجر من ظهور الفجر الصادق إلى ظهور القرص. نعم.
And the time for the Fajr prayer is when the true sunrise appears until the disk of the sun it becomes apparent, it rises.
هناك أوقات خمسة نهينا عن الصلاة فيها. نعم.
There are 5 times when we are not allowed to, when we are being prohibited from praying. 5 times.
من تسليم الإمام من صلاة الفجر إلى أن يظهر القرص.
From when the Imam says his Taslim, when he finishes his Fajr prayer, all the way until the sun has completely risen.
ومن ظهور قرص الشمس إلى أن ترتفع الشمس مقدار رمح يعني لا ترى الشمس أمامك حتى لا تكون كالساجد أو الراكع لها وهذا بالساعة الآن مقدار ربع ساعة تقريبا من ظهور القرص إلى أن ترتفع. نعم.
And also the amount which is about 15 minutes, and this is when once the sun has risen and it has appeared, when it is risen more, i.e. you don't see the sun in front of you such that when you're prostrating, it's as if you're prostrating to the sun. So about 15 minutes after the sun has risen, after the sun has appeared above the horizon, about 15 or 20 minutes longer, after in this time you still cannot pray.
ثم الوقت الثالث الذي ذكرناه عندما تكون الشمس ليس لها ظل يعني على رؤوس الخلائق أن هذا الوقت الذي تسعر فيه نار جهنم نسأل الله العافية والسلام. نعم.
And also we have mentioned that the third prohibited time for a person to pray, he's not allowed to pray in this time, is when the sun is on top of creation, on top of, for example, a stick. When a stick or a person does not have a shadow because the sun is right at the top.
الوقت الرابع من تسليم الإمام من صلاة العصر إلى أن تدنو الشمس من الغروب.
And also the fourth time is once the Imam finishes the Asr prayer and he makes his taslim all the way until the sun is about to go down into sunrise, sunset. And then from when the sun is setting, from when the sun has approached its sunset until it has set, then this is also time for in which a person cannot pray.
نعم واجب أن تصلي الصلاة في وقت عام ذكرنا.
So the obligation is for a person to pray each prayer in its time as we have mentioned.
ويحرم تأخير الصلاة عن وقتها.
And it is impermissible, it is prohibited for a person to delay its delay his prayer from its legislated time.
وإذا أدرك ركعة من الصلاة في الوقت فقد أدرك وقت الصلاة.
So as long as a person catches or completes at least one unit of prayer in its legislated time, then he has caught the prayer.
والأصل أن تصلي الصلوات المفروضة في أول الوقت. نعم هذا أفضل والأحوط والأبرأ للذمة وهذا الذي كان عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن تصلي الصلاة في أول الوقت أحوط وأبرأ للذمة. نعم.
And the best time for a person to pray his prayers, and that which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do, and that which is most fulfilling for a person's responsibility.
لا يترك هذا التوزيع الآن لا يشغلون لهم هم من دون أن توزع أنت اللي مشتغل بالجوال واللي متكئ واللي يتكلم مع زميله لو وزعت الماء والعصير الله أعلم أصبحنا كأننا في حفلة إحنا في درس علمي نعطيهم بعد الدرس إن شاء الله تعالى خمس دقائق أو عشر دقائق يعني يستمتع فيها في اللعب في الجوال والشرب والأكل إخواننا ما تستطيع تحبس أنفاسك في درس علمي في محاضرة في كذا مدة ساعة وتستطيع تحبس أنفاسك عند يعني أنا لا أريد أمثل بأشياء إخواننا هذا درس علمي ما يمكن أن في الدرس العلمي الذي يأخذ جوال يلعب به والذي يشرب والذي يتكئ والذي يمد رجليه إخواننا جبريل عليه السلام أفضل منكم ومني جاء إلى مجلس النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم جلس جلسة المتأدب المتعلم لم يمد رجليه ولم يتكئ ولم يأتي بطعام وشراب أو يعبث يلعب بالجوال بعض الناس واللي أكل لبان مثلا واللي أكل فصفص وكذا مثلا ما هذا؟ لو يدخل كافر الآن يقول إيش هذا؟ ما يليق هذا يا إخواننا هذا درس علمي هذا جبريل قال عليه السلام قال عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه معلم معلم وهو جاء طالب علم سائل لكن معلم أثر ظهرت عليه آثار طلب العلم في لباسه في جلوسه في إنصاته للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يقاطعه ما قال عندي سؤال وعندي كذا وعندي كذا هذا لا يترجع طيب
So we said that the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and that which is better and that which is safe and that which is more fulfilling of your responsibility is that you pray each prayer in its in the beginning of its time.
أحسن ذكرنا أن الصلاة الأصل أن تصلى في أول الوقت هذا الأحوط الأبرأ للذمة وهذا فعل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نعم
As I mentioned That which is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and is better and more rewarding and is more fulfilling of your responsibility is that you pray each prayer in the beginning of its legislated time.
إلا أن السنة أن تؤخر صلاة الظهر عند اشتداد الحر ما لم يشق على الجماعة وكذلك صلاة العشاء نعم السنة أن تؤخر صلاة الظهر عند اشتداد الحر يعني في فصل الصيف نعم ما لم يشق على الجماعة نعم
However, the exception to this and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that in those days when it is very very warm then it's better for a person to delay his prayer so the heat of the sun it doesn't harm the people so as long as the heat of the sun is harming the people, is difficult upon the people, then it's better for a person to delay the prayer. And also that the people, they should delay their Isha prayer as long as this isn't difficult for the people.
لكن بعض الناس هدانا الله إياه يقول أنا أريد أن أعمل بالسنة أخر الصلاة في فصل الصيف يترك صلاة الجماعة والتي هي واجبة بل أن ترك الجماعة كبيرة من كبائر الذنوب ويقول أريد أن أحافظ على السنة هذا من تلبيس إبليس عليه نعم.
However, some people, may Allah guide us and guide them, they say that we want to implement the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in delaying our dhuhr prayer because it is very warm outside. It's hot weather outside, so we want to implement the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by delaying our dhuhr prayer. But what they do is they miss the congregation, so they don't pray with the congregation, and instead they pray at home. We said that praying in congregation, this is wajib, this is an obligation, and missing it is a major sin from amongst the major sins. So this person who does this, he misses the obligation, and yet he wants to fulfill the sunnah, the recommendation, then in reality this is a deception of shaitan against him.
هذا ما يتعلق والله أعلم بشروط الصلاة واجبات الصلاة نعم.
So this is what relates to
أركان الصلاة أركان الصلاة.
So this is what relates to the conditions of the prayer. As for the pillars, the أركان, the pillars of the prayer.
الركن الأول القيام مع القدرة لا بد من القيام في صلاة الفريضة نعم. فالقيام في صلاة الفريضة ركن من أركان الصلاة نعم.
نشرح الركن ما هو الركن.
الركن هذا البناء الآن له أركان أربعة لو أسقطنا ركن من هذه الأركان الأربعة انهار البناء فالصلاة لها أركان لو نسقط ركن واحد من هذه الأركان أصبحت الصلاة عندنا باطلة لا تصح ولا يقبل في ترك الركن لا جهل ولا نسيان ولا عمد سيأتي معنا بإذن الله تعالى نعم.
So a ركن is a pillar. For example now this hall of this building it has four pillars. If one of these four pillars were to be destroyed, then the whole building would come down. And this is like the prayer. In the prayer, there are certain actions which are considered as being a pillar of the prayer. If one of these actions are not there or they are missing, then the whole prayer is not acceptable or correct. And therefore, the arkan of the prayer are...
الركن الأول القيام في صلاة الفريضة لكن مع القدرة على القيام. نعم.
So, the first pillar is that a person prays standing up as long as he has the ability to pray standing up and this is only in the obligatory prayers. It's a pillar in the obligatory prayers.
فكيف نعرف أنه قادر أو غير قادر على القيام؟
So how do we know whether a person has the ability to stand up in the obligatory prayers or he doesn't have the ability?
لا يقدر على القيام بالكلية كأن يكون نسأل الله العافية والسلامة مشلول مثلا فهذا لا يقدر على القيام بالكلية نعم.
If we have a person who is, for example, paralyzed, and he isn't able to stand up at all.
أو يقول أنا أقدر على القيام لكن يحصل لي ألم شديد ولا أخشع في صلاتي فهذا غير قادر على القيام يصلي جالسا نعم.
And also there is another person who does have the ability to stand up, but he says that if I stand up, it's very painful for me. It's very hard for me, and when I stand up, I'm not able to concentrate in my prayer. Again, this type of person, we say that he doesn't have the ability to stand up and pray.
لكن البعض يقول أنا أقدر على شيء من القيام. نقول لابد أن تقوم هذا الذي تقدر عليه. ومتى جاء على التعب اجلس. نعم.
And other people, they say that I'm able to stand up for a short while. But then when I prolong this standing, it starts to hurt me or I get pain. So we say to this person that as long as you are able to stand up, then you should stand and this is the obligation, this is the pillar. However, as soon as the pain starts setting in, then you sit down.
وهذا نراه اليوم في من يصلي على الكراسي. تجده ما شاء الله يأتي سيرا على أقدام المسجد. ثم يأتي وضع الكرسي ويجلس. ثم بعد هذا يكبر تكبيرة الإحرام هذا خطأ نعم.
We see some people that they come walking to the masjid and then they pick the chair up and they take it to the front and they place the chair and then when it comes for the time of the prayer they sit down and then they say the تكبيرة الإحرام they begin the prayer so this is incorrect.
نقول لهم الأصل أن تقوم متى جاء التعب جاء الألم اجلس زال الألم ترجع وتقوم على هذا نعم.
So we say to this person that the obligation upon you, the pillar of the prayer for you is that you have to stand up. When you start feeling pain, then you sit down. Once this pain goes, then you stand up again.
أما النافلة يصح أن يصلي النافلة جالسا لكن له نصف أجر القائم. نعم.
And as for the voluntary prayers, the nawafil, then it's permitted for a person to pray them while sitting down. However, if he prays them sitting down, then his reward is half of the person who prayed them standing up.
نعم. بعد القيام مع القدرة تكبيرة الإحرام. نعم.
And then after standing up and praying, if he has the ability to do so, then the next pillar of the prayer is takbiratul ihram, i.e. the first takbirah, the first time you say Allahu Akbar.
Takbiratul ihram huwa qawl Allahu Akbar. Wa qad yadhun ba'd an-nas anna takbiratul ihram hiya raf' al-yadayn. Raf' al-yadayn shay' wa qawl Allahu Akbar shay' akhar. Na'am.
Takbiratul ihram is the first instance a person says Allahu Akbar when starting the prayer. Some people think that takbiratul ihram means a person raising his hands. Rather, a person raising his hands and a person saying Allahu Akbar and the takbiratul ihram, they're two different things.
ثم بعد هذا قراءة الفاتحة.
And then after this, the next pillar is a person reciting Surah Al-Fatiha.
فلا بد من قراءة الفاتحة.
So a person has to recite Surah Al-Fatiha.
كاملة.
All of it, completely.
مرتبة.
In its right order.
بآياتها.
With all of its ayat.
وكلماتها.
And all of its words.
وحروفها.
And all of its letters.
وحركاتها.
And even all of its vowels.
لو ترك منها حرف واحد أو حركة واحدة فالصلاة باطلة.
If a person leaves even one word of Surah Al-Fatiha, or he doesn't recite one vowel of Surah Al-Fatiha, then his prayer is invalid and not accepted.
Yep, la bud min qira'at al-Fatiha fi kull rak'ah.
And a person has to recite Surah Al-Fatiha in every single unit of the prayer.
في السرية وفي الجهرية وفي الحضر وفي السفر.
Whether this prayer is from the quiet prayers or the loud prayers, or he's traveling, or he's resident, he has to recite Surah Al-Fatiha in every single rak'ah.
وَلَا تَسْقُطُ الْفَاتِحَ بِأَيْ حَالٍ مِنَ الْأَحْوَالِ إِلَّا فِي حَالَ وَاحِدَ فَقَطْ.
And the obligation to recite Surah Al-Fatiha as a pillar of the prayer, then this obligation is not removed in any instance except in one exception.
إِذَا دَخَلْ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدْ وَجَدَ الْإِمَامُ رَاكِعًا يكبر تكبيرة الإحرام ثم يكبر تكبيرة الركوع وإذا ركع مع الإمام الركوع تسقط عنه الفاتحة وتحسب له هذه الركعة. نعم.
So the only exception in which a person does not have to recite the Surah Al-Fatiha is when a person comes late to the prayer. He comes late to the prayer and he sees the Imam, he's already in ruku, in bowing. So he says Allahu Akbar for his تكبيرة الإحرام. And then he says Allahu Akbar and he goes down to the bowing straight away. As long as he catches the ruku', the bowing of the imam, then he has caught the whole rak'ah, the whole unit of the prayer.
وَلَوْ أَدْرَكَ الْإِمَامُ رَاكِعًا وَكَبَّرْ تَكْبِيرًا وَاحِدًا وَنَوَى بِهَا تَكْبِيرَةَ الْإِحْرَامِ فَالصَّلَاةُ صَحِيحًا نَوَى بِهَا تَكْبِيرَةَ الرُّكُوعِ لَمْ يَدْخُلْ فِي الصَّلَاةِ أَصْلًا فَالصَّلَاةُ بَاطِلَةٌ. نعم.
And if a person comes late to the prayer and he finds the imam in ruku', in bowing, and he says Allahu Akbar. But when he says Allahu Akbar, he didn't intend the first Allahu Akbar, the first takbir of al-ihram, but rather he intended in his mind that this is the takbir of going into bowing. Then here he hasn't even entered into the prayer and therefore his prayer is not accepted.
ثم بعد هذا الركوع.
And then the next pillar after this is the ruku', is the bowing.
ثم الاعتدال والرفع من الركوع.
And then the next pillar of the prayer is al-i'tidal, which is when a person stands up, he stands up fully and properly.
ثم السجود على الأعضاء السبعة.
And then the next pillar is a person going into prostration and making sujood upon his seven limbs.
الجبهة والأنف.
And the seven limbs are the forehead and the nose.
وباطن الكفين.
And the palms of the two hands.
والركبتين.
And the two knees.
وباطن أصابع الرجلين.
And the bottommost parts of the toes. All these are the seven limbs that a person must prostrate upon.
السجدة الأولى والسجدة الثانية.
And a person has to prostrate the first prostration and the second prostration, the first sujood and the second sujood.
ثم الجلسة بين السجدتين.
And also, from the pillars of the prayer is the sitting between the two sujoods.
ثم الترتيب بين الأركان. لابد أن يرتب ويصلي الصلاة مرتبة.
And then the next pillar is for a person to perform all these actions in the correct order, in the correct sequence.
ولابد من الطمأنينة في جميع الأركان. And الطمأنينة هو أن يطمئن في ركوع وفي سجود وفي قيام وفي كل الأركان وتتحقق الطمأنينة بأن يأتي بالذكر الواجب في كل ركن من الأركان. فلو قال مثلا في ركوع سبحان ربي العظيم في الغالب أنه حقق الطمأنينة. في السجود قال مرة واحدة سبحان ربي الأعلى في الغالب حقق الطمأنينة. نعم.
And then the next pillar is الطمأنينة, tranquility. A person being tranquil and calm in his prayer. And the meaning of tranquility or the meaning of tuma'nina is that in every part of the prayer, whether it's the ruku' or the sujood or any part of the prayer, the person says completely and perfectly that which he should say. As an example, if the person is bowing and he says Subhana Rabbi al-Azim and he says it perfectly and completely, then this is tuma'nina, this is tranquility.
نعم. ثم التشهد الأخير أي قراءة التشهد الأخير قول التحيات لله إلى آخر. نعم.
And then the last pillar and then another pillar of the prayer is the final تشهد, meaning he's saying التحيات لله.
التشهد الأخير أي التشهد الذي يليه تسليم الصلاة. نعم.
And the meaning of the final تشهد is the final تشهد which is before the تسليم.
والجلوس له لأنه قد يقرأ التشهد وهو قائم أو راكع أو ساجد.
And also from the pillars of the prayer is sitting for the last tashahud because a person might stand up and recite that tashahud. So he has to sit and recite that tashahud.
والصلاة على النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم الصلاة الإبراهيمية.
And also from the pillars of the prayer is a person sending salutations and blessings upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam upon the way of Ibrahim, i.e. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad and that which you know.
نعم. والتسليم الأولى والتسليم الثاني.
And then the final pillar of the prayer is for a person to make the first taslim and the second taslim.
هذا ما يتعلق والله أعلم بأركان الصلاة.
So this is what relates to the pillars of the prayer and Allah knows best.
واجبات الصلاة.
The obligations, the wajibat, the obligations of the prayer.
واجبات الصلاة جميع التكبيرات على تكبيرة الإحرام.
So the obligations or the obligatory matters in the prayer which a person has to do are all of the تكبيرات except the first تكبيرة.
أي مثلا تكبيرة الركوع, تكبيرة السجود, تكبيرة الرفع من السجود, كل تكبيرات الصلاة عدا تكبيرة الإحرام. فهذه التكبيرات ركن من أركان الصلاة. تكبيرة الإحرام كما ذكرنا ركن. جميع التكبيرات من واجبات الصلاة. أما تكبيرة الإحرام فهي ركن من أركان الصلاة. نعم.
So for example, a person saying Allahu Akbar when bowing. A person saying Allahu Akbar when going down into sujood. A person saying Allahu Akbar when standing up from the sujood. So every time a person has to say Allahu Akbar, then this is an obligation. This is the from the wajibat of the prayer. As for the first takbira, then as mentioned, this is a rukn, a pillar from the pillars of the prayer.
قول سبحان ربي العظيم في ركوعي مرة واحدة. هذا من واجبات الصلاة.
And from the obligations of the prayer is for a person to say سبحان ربي العظيم at least once in his ركوع, in his bowing.
إذا لابد من قول سبحان ربي العظيم مرة واحدة في ركوع.
And therefore, a person has to say سبحان ربي العظيم at least once in his bowing, in his ركوع.
ويستحب له أن يزيد بما ورد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام المرة الثانية سبحان ربي العظيم أو سبح قدوس رب الملائكة والروح أو سبحانك اللهم ربنا بحمدك اللهم اغفر. المهم لابد أن يقول مرة واحدة سبحان ربي العظيم في ركوعه.
And then after this, a person can say the extra additional supplications or remembrances that came from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But at the least, he has to say one time Subhana Rabbi al-Azim in his bowing, in his ruku'.
وقول سمع الله لمن حمده للإمام والمنفرد.
And also a person saying سبحان رب سمع الله لمن حمده for the person who is an imam and also for the person who is praying alone and not in congregation. They have to say سمع الله لمن حمده.
وقول ربنا ولك الحمد للإمام والمنفرد وللمأموم يعني للجميع.
And as for saying ربنا ولك الحمد, then the imam and the person who is praying in congregation behind the imam and also the person who is praying alone and not in congregation, all of these people have to say ربنا ولك الحمد.
واستحب له أن يزيد بما ورد إلى ربي الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه وغير هذا من أدعية النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الواردة عنه.
And then it is a recommendation for a person to add to this whatever has been narrated from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قول سبحان ربي الأعلى مرة واحدة في سجوده.
And also from the wajibat, from the obligations of the prayer is for a person to say at least once سبحان ربي الأعلى in his sujood, in his prostration.
قول رب اغفر لي مرة واحدة بين السجدتين واستحب له أن يزيد. نعم.
And also from the wajibat is for a person to say رب اغفر لي at least once when in his sitting between the two prostrations, and it is recommended for a person to say it more than once.
والتشهد الأول أي في الصلاة الثلاثية والرباعية أي قراءة التشهد الأول في الصلاة التي فيها أكثر من تشهد. نعم.
And also from the obligations of the prayer is for a person to say the first tashahud, for a person to recite the first tashahud where there are two tashahud in the prayer. So when there's a prayer of 3 units or 4 units and there's 2 times a person says tashahud, then the obligation is to say the first tashahud.
والجلوس له أي الجلوس لهذا التشهد التشهد الأول من واجبات الصلاة.
And also for a person to sit for the first tashahud, it's an obligation.
الآن نذكر مبطلات الصلاة.
And now we are going to mention those actions which invalidate a person's prayer.
قبل هذا نريد أن نبين أنواع الحركات في الصلاة.
So before this, we want to explain the different types of movements in the prayer.
الحركات في الصلاة 5 أنواع.
The different types of movements in the prayer are 5. There's 5 different types of movements in the prayer.
حركة محرمة.
The type of movement which is not allowed.
وحركة مكروهة.
The movement which is disliked.
وحركة مباحة.
The movement which is permitted.
وحركة مستحبة.
The movement which is recommended.
وحركة واجب.
And the movement which is an obligation.
الحركة المحرمة.
So the movement in the prayer which is not permitted, it is
الأكل.
Eating.
والشرب.
Drinking.
والضحك.
Laughing.
والالتفات الكثير عن القبلة.
And also a person moving away or diverting away from the قبلة.
والحركة الكثيرة المتتابعة لغير حاجة حتى تنظر إليه تظن غير مصلي. حركة كثيرة ومتتابعة ولغير حاجة وتنظر إليه تظن غير مصلي. نعم.
And also a person moving consistently, a person moving such without any need, such that if a person was to look at him, he would think that he's not praying.
يعني ما هو يصلي الآن يدق الجوال يأخذ الجهاز وانظر في الرسائل ويقول سبحان الله لماذا يتصل علينا في هذا الوقت هذا أو يقول له أنا أصلي مثلا. حركة كثيرة متوالية عرفا يعني في العرف تنظر إليه تظن غير مصلي ولغير حاجة. نعم.
An example of this is a person who whilst he is praying his phone is ringing. So he takes his phone out, he looks at it, he switches it off, he reads through those messages, or he answers the phone call and he says, I'm in the prayer, don't ring me. So this type of movement, it is muharrama, it's not allowed. I.e. moving the prayer, constantly moving, in which normally a person will look at this person and think that this person isn't praying. So this is the impermissible type of movement in the prayer. And then the second type of movement are those movements which are
disliked.
So this is a person moving a little in the prayer, but he does so without any necessity. Such that if a person was to look at him, he will know that he is praying. But he's doing it without any necessity and it's only a little amount of movement.
التفات يصير في الصلاة.
So, and also a person moving slightly in the prayer.
نعم. الحركة المباحة.
And then those movements which are permitted.
هي الحركة التي تكون لحاجة. الحركة تكون لحاجة. محتاج لهذه الحركة. مثال دق الجوال فبأدنى حركة أدخل يده في جيبه وجعل الجوال على الصامت. نعم.
The permitted or the permissible type of movements in the prayer is any movement that a person has to do as a necessity. As an example, a person is praying and his mobile starts ringing. So with the least amount of movement, he puts his hand in his pocket and he switches off his mobile and then he returns his hand back. This is now something which is permitted due to a necessity.
عندما سجد في صلاته سقطت 50 باوند من جيبه وخاف عليها من السرقة فبأدنى حركة أخذ وضعها في جيبه حركة مباحة جائزة.
When a person is in sujood, when he prostrates, let's say 50 pounds falls out of his pocket and he's scared that somebody might come and steal or take this 50 pounds while he's in the prayer. So with the least amount of movement, he takes his money and he puts it back in his pocket. This is something which is permitted due to a necessity.
حركة مستحبة.
And then we have those movements in the prayer which are recommended, which are mustahab.
هي الحركة التي نتوقف عليها كمال الصلاة. نعم.
And they are those movements in which a person perfects his prayer.
يعني إن لم يتحرك كانت الصلاة صحيحة لكن ناقصة في الأجر.
Meaning that if a person doesn't fulfill this recommended type of movement, although his prayer is correct and valid, but it's not the most perfect, the reward is deficient.
سد الفرج.
For example, a person closing the gap.
الحركة الواجبة هي الحركة التي إن لم يتحرك بها كانت الصلاة باطلة.
And then those movements in the prayer which are an obligation, or those movements, if a person doesn't do them, then his prayer isn't accepted.
الآن هو صلي مثلا وجد على غترته نجاسة مثلا وجد نجاسة على غترته أو على الجاكيت مثلا.
As an example, a person is praying and in the middle of the prayer he finds on his scarf or on his jacket some form of impurity.
فماذا يصنع؟
So therefore, what does this person do?
لابد أن يخلع هذا الجاكيت أو يخلع هذا. فهذا هنا يجب عليه أن يتحرك هذه الحركة. نعم.
That this person has to now take off his jacket and remove his jacket because of the impurity on it.
نعم. مبطلات الصلاة.
And then therefore this is an obligatory form of movement in the prayer.
الكلام.
So now we come to those actions which invalidate the prayer, that break the person's prayer.
الكلام العمد مع العلم والذكر. يتكلم متعمدا عالما تحرم الكلام في الصلاة ذاكرا لا ناسيا. نعم.
Is a person who speaks intentionally and he knows that speaking the prayer breaks his prayer and he does so intentionally, i.e. not out of forgetfulness.
فلو تكلم ناسيا.
So if a person speaks in the prayer out of forgetfulness
أو جاهل تحريم الكلام في الصلاة,
or a person speaks in the prayer but he doesn't know the ruling of speaking in the prayer,
أو تكلم لمصلحة الصلاة أخطأ الإمام ففتح عليه وأخذ ينبه الإمام,
or a person speaks in the prayer but only to correct the Imam, he realizes that Imam has made a mistake in his recitation so he corrects him in the recitation.
فالصلاة صحيحة وإلا فهي باطلة.
The prayer is correct and anything else in the prayer becomes invalid.
الكلام العمد متعمد.
We said the person who speaks on purpose.
عالم تحريم الكلام في الصلاة.
And he knows the ruling of speaking the prayer that it isn't permissible.
ذاكرا لا ناسيا.
And he knows and he intends it and he isn't it isn't out of forgetfulness.
فالصلاة باطلة.
So then, if he does this, then his prayer is invalid.
الأكل.
Eating.
الشرب.
Drinking.
الضحك.
Laughing.
الالتفات الكثير عن القبلة.
Moving or diverting away from the Qibla a lot.
الحركة الكثيرة المتوالية عرفا لغير حاجة.
And we said also, a person moving a lot consistently so that the people around him, they know, they think that he's not in the prayer.
انكشاف العورة.
And also from those matters which invalidate a person's prayer is the awra, the private parts to become uncovered.
وهذا يحصل في من يصلي في البنطار.
And this often happens with those people who pray in trousers.
تكون صلاته باطلة عند الركوع عند السجود.
That often the case is that when he makes sujood, when he prostrates, when he bows, then his prayer becomes invalid.
يعني إن انكشفت العورة. فيحتاط قبل الدخول في الصلاة إنه لا تنكشف العورة عند الركوع عند السجود. نعم.
So his prayer becomes invalid if his awra becomes it becomes uncovered, and therefore a person should be careful before he enters into the prayer to make sure that his awra will remain covered in the prayer.
وانتقاض الطهارة.
And also
مبطلات الصلاة. يعني مثلا خرج منه ريح وهو يصلي. فماذا يصنع؟ يتم الصلاة؟ الصلاة الآن باطل. لابد أن يخرج. يقدم الخوف من الله سبحانه وتعالى. يخرج يتوضأ ويرجع. نعم.
And also when a person's wudu breaks, if a person's wudu breaks, if a person passes wind whilst he's in the prayer, then his prayer is invalid. And therefore he should fear Allah, go out and make his wudu and come back for the prayer.
نأخذ تقريبا 10 دقائق إلى الساعة 7 إن شاء الله تعالى. نرتاح فيها ونراجع. ثم بعد هذا نواصل ما بدأنا فيه. والله أعلم. صلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.
Turn up to 10 minutes.